So at the smallest omics level, we have genomics, and that's the study of genomes, or all of the DNA for a particular species. So we could be talking about the mouse genome, or the corn genome, or the human genome, and we're figuring out all the A, T, C's, and G's for each of these species. The Human Genome Project is an important project I'll talk about here in a minute. And then we're going to talk a little bit about the implications of genomics, including comparative genomics, functional genomics, personal genomics, and epigenomics. So the Human Genome Project was a 13-year project to map out the human genome. So the Human Genome Project is now available to everyone as a public database. Originally, there were two different groups working on figuring out all those ATCs and Gs. Towards the end of the project, the government encouraged them to work together, and it was decided that instead of the human genome being a private thing that someone had to pay for, that it would be a public database that was available to everyone. And it is, in fact, available to you if you want to go do a search. I can give you a brief example here. This is a website that's maintained by the National Institutes of Health, and you can search for all kinds of things. There's a lot on here. You can browse by organism to see what they've accomplished. You may or may not remember that I am a bat biologist. Myotis are the little brown bats. And notice three of our species, we have complete genomes available. Isn't that a cute little face? Another option is to go to the human genome, and we could do a search for something we are maybe interested in. Maybe you wanted to find out what genes are involved in eye color. Eye color is more complex than just a single gene, but we can do a quick browse. And here we've got a list of the genes that have been identified as somehow involved. And notice there's some on chromosome 15, some on chromosome 17. If we click on one of these, we've got a lot of information about the chromosome and exactly where this is found on it. So here we are zoomed in on this little part of chromosome 15, and here we have a recoding region, and I'm going to click on here. This is going to show all the people involved in figuring out this particular section of this particular gene and the processes that it took to do that. And then the FASTA will actually show the code. So here we have the T, A, C's, and G's for that particular section of that particular gene. This website will also allow you to do blast searches so you can compare different genomes and actually see what certain genes have in common. This is a very powerful database, and it takes some practice to get used to how to use it, but once you can, it's a very powerful tool for biotechnology. This video will give you a nice overview of the history of the Human Genome Project.